Well, it's something I follow myself, so it must be good, right?
Yeah, look who's talking.
Leaving a sibling jokes aside, let me, Bhavyadarji,
and I, Ananya Vaidyapan, now take you through today's assembly.
So now, I would like to call upon Sharvari Velankar to say the prayers.
Om Sahana Bhavatu Sahana Bhunatu Sahaviryam करवावहै तेजस्विना वधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषां वहै ॐ शान्तिः 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 या पुण्येन्द्रतुषारहारधवला या शुभ्रवस्त्रामृता या वीणा वरदंड मंडित करा या श्वेत पद्मासना या ब्रह्मांचुत शंकरा प्रभुति देवै सदा वंदिता सा मां पातु सरस्वती भगवती निशेष जाड्य पाहा।
So, it's always been fun hearing inspiring stories from our grandparents about great leaders like Mahatma Gandhi, isn't it?
Now, let's enter the Gandhian era. I would like to call upon Sharvari Velankar and Neel Naik.
Namaste, I am Meerabai.
And I am Pannalal. We are the followers of our beloved and respected Bapu. We have supported him from 1916, that is, the first Satyagraha campaign in Champaran.
To the year, our motherland India got its independence from the British Empire.
Yes, we have experienced and learned a lot from his morals and values that we will treasure forever in our lives.
He always preached ahimsa, that is non-cooperation and non-violence. He not only preached it, but also practiced it to achieve his goals. Bapu always said, and I quote, "Non-cooperation with evil is as much as a duty as cooperation with the good," unquote.
Yes, very true. He believed in equality, so he could not stand the oppressed and the downtrodden being looked down upon. He called the untouchables as Harijans or the children of God and requested people to respect them.
Even Congress adopted many programs for the upliftment of the Harijans as well as social issues faced by us in that era.
The life of Bapu has inspired millions of people all over the globe, including eminent personalities like Martin Luther King Jr. and Nelson Mandela. Bapu not only inspired the common man during India's freedom struggle from the British Empire, but his visions and actions have been an enduring significance for all times and places.
But the constant factor which his notion of Satyagraha is surely the greatest gift to India as well as the whole world.
Upon the death of Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, he was hailed by the London Times as the most influential figure India has produced for generations. Bapu protested against racism in South Africa and colonial rule in India using non-violent resistance. He was armed with so much courage and the feeling of non-violent resistance that he took on one of the mightiest empires in the world without arms.
A practical idealist as he is described as, Bapu has left a rich legacy for the human emancipation and sustainability. When pressed for a message, he offered the now famous quote, "My life is my message," unquote. Thank you.
Now, let us have Tanmay Karandikar portray Gandhiji's character and brief us about the events in his life.
I, Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, was born on 2nd October 1869 at Porbandar in present-day Gujarat. My father was the Diwan of Porbandar. My mother was Putlibai Gandhi. From a very young age, I was influenced by my mother to a staunch devotion to God and his tenets of non-violence and love for all. On completing my primary and secondary education, I went to London to study law. While I studied law in the University of London, I found it difficult to adapt to the Western lifestyle and etiquettes. In the boarding houses and Indian clubs of London, I was introduced to many religious texts such as the Bible and the Gita. These greatly influenced my personality and my actions. In 1891, I accepted a job offer from an Indian firm in Natal, South Africa. My time in South Africa was eye-opening. I was exposed to the racial bias that the Indians suffered. I was thrown out of the first class of a train, even though I possessed a ticket. I was beaten by a white stagecoach driver for denying to stand in the footboard to make room for the European passengers. This was the moment when I decided to change the perspective of people. I educated them to battle this bias and realize their rights and duties in the society. My active life in Indian politics began with Kheda and Champaran Satyagraha. Champaran Satyagraha was a non-violent protest against the exploitation of indigo farmers. In Kheda Satyagraha, I helped the farmers gain concession on land revenue when their crops failed. My main objective was to lay stress on non-violence and unity, for it was essential for the freedom struggle. Even I faced many failures, like the suspension of the civil disobedience movement because of the Chauri Chaura incident, and many more. Yet, I remained persistent and was deeply rooted in the soil of my non-violent ideals. Even though the opposition showed violence, I encouraged my followers to stick to ahimsa, kindness, selflessness and satyagraha. Hence, these lessons taught to me by my life are priceless, and these should be inculcated in the youth for the future of democratic India.
Thank you, Tanmay. We were surely enlightened by it.
Today, along with Gandhi Jayanti, we are also commemorating the birth anniversary of Lal Bahadur Shastri Ji. So, I would like to call upon Jai Veerankar to tell us more about our former Prime Minister.
I am Lal Bahadur Shastri. I was born on 2nd October 1908. I was brought up by my parents, Prasad Srivastava, my father, and Ramdulari Devi, my mother, in a small village of Ramdul. There, I studied for a few years and enrolled in the Harish Chandra High School in Varanasi. My teachers there were staunch supporters and activists in the freedom struggle of India. My head teacher, Harish Mishra, provided much needed financial support, and his patriotism inspired me to take a deep interest in the activism of our nation. Later, I took up history, but I left it to join the Congress Party, actively participating in the anti-government initiatives. There, I also rallied along Mahatma Gandhi in the non-cooperation movement, but was imprisoned for a few years. On release, I studied at the Kashi Vidyapeeth, where I graduated with a first-class degree in philosophy and ethics. In 1942, I was released from prison and I immediately travelled to Allahabad, where I helped several independence activists in the Quit India movement. Following the independence of India, I was appointed as a Minister of Police and Transport in Uttar Pradesh on 15th August 1947. The Independence Day of India. As my first act of being the Transport Minister, I appointed women conductors. Later, in 1951, I was made the General Secretary of All India Congress Committee, with Jawaharlal Nehru as a Prime Minister. I was directly responsible for the selection of candidates. I also served as a Minister of Commerce and Industry in 1959 and the Minister of Home Affairs in 1961. Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru died in office on 27 May 1968. President K. Kamaraj of Congress entitled me the position of Prime Minister. There comes a time in the life of every nation when it stands at the crossroads of history and must choose which way to go. But for us, there need no be difficulty nor hesitation. No looking to the right or left. Our way is straight and clear. The building up of the socialist democracy at home with freedom and prosperity for all, and the maintenance of world's peace and friendship with all nations. This is my message.
Thank you so much, Jai.
Gandhiji inspired millions. Many great leaders like Nelson Mandela, Barack Obama, Steve Jobs were inspired by Gandhi's principles. He believed that it was his responsibility to fight for India's rights. He played a pivotal role in the attainment of freedom from the British. He changed history. He followed the three great principles, Satya, Ahimsa and non-violence. It was due to his contribution that India attained freedom from untouchability and learned simplicity and faith.
It not only changed the lives of the people, but also assured India's great glorious present as well as future. So, I would like to conclude today's assembly with a quote by Gandhiji. I quote, "If we want to have real peace in the world, we must educate children." I unquote. So, as children of Palitilak Vidyalaya ICSE, we all pledge to have a better and a promising future for our country, India.
Question here, this is my only fear, that we become beautiful people.